This is the Bax and Grant Sports Show. Welcome inside studio, back to Colburn, alongside Grant Coppersmith. Oh, Grant, the end is near, not in a bad way, in a good way. Finals week is finally here, and we are able to finally relax a little bit. I mean, I only have one more final left. I don't know how many finals you have, but how many finals do you have, Grant?
Just have two.
Just have two. Me as well. I don't feel as guilty now. I had a conversation with some of my friends this morning, and they were like, oh, yeah, we have, you know, four, five, six finals. I was like, oh, my gosh, I feel terrible for you. And they're like, how many do you have? I'm like, I have two. And I got kicked out of the table. So they weren't too happy with me in that regard. But, you know, Grant, there was a lot of football this weekend.
There was a lot of football.
And you and I are very excited anytime football occurs in the world. And I think there were some people that in the NFL that warranted what I got dealt today with my friends. I got kicked out of the table. I feel like I should be – there's teams in the NFL that need to be kicked out because they just played dreadful this weekend. Don't you agree?
I definitely do agree with how Colin Kaepernick has been doing. The 49ers are just an implosion. They started off all right at the beginning of the season, but it's just been a nosedive since about the middle of the season, and it's just not looking good for them. The future of the program, I really don't know what to say about that. They're, in my opinion, they're just out of the playoffs. Don't even think that they're going to make it, even though they're technically still in it with their record, but how their team has been playing, it's just dreadful.
Yeah, they by no means deserve to be in the playoff conversation at all. They are 7-6 right now, but after you lose to a now 2-11 Raiders team, you let a rookie quarterback torch your secondary for 3 touchdowns. Raiders take the 24-13 victory. It's just there's nowhere really to go after that. You're like, well, we lost to the best team in we lost to the worst team in the NFL. I, as a coach, I would have a really hard time motivating my players for the next week game. Be like, hey, we still got this. We're still in a chance. But I mean, is there any hope for the 49ers? I honestly think their season's done. I think Kaepernick is terrible. I think I heard a very interesting thing this morning from ESPN Milwaukee writer Jason Wildy. He said that the San Francisco 49ers fell in love with Kaepernick because he had a good season and a half. And after that, they pretty much gave him the keys to the team and said, hey, go have fun. Go run around like you did against Green Bay in the playoffs. Go lead us back to a Super Bowl, you know, and go from there. But they took zero time to develop Kaepernick like you compare him to a guy like Aaron Rodgers. And I know that's not a fair comparison, but Aaron Rodgers has learned under Brett Favre. He has got consistent coaching all throughout his career. Even now, he still has a lot of coaching that makes him a great player. Colin Kaepernick, he had a great season and a half, and now San Francisco is like, oh, we're fine. We don't need to worry about anything.
And the 49ers also had Alex Smith at the time, who was doing fantastic. And then he got injured, and then Colin Kaepernick came in, and instead of putting Alex Smith back, and then maybe, like you were saying, developing Colin Kaepernick, they kind of just pulled a surprising move and just got rid of Alex Smith altogether and said, we're done with you, when he was having a fantastic season up to the injury. So I do agree that was, well, maybe not agree, I just am stating that I think that was a bad call on the 49ers part. I definitely think they should have waited. Like you said, they should have developed him a lot more than they have, because right now they're not doing well. And next week they have a Seattle Seahawks team that's heating up, and that's going to be a tough game for them, and it's not going to be easy at all.
Nobody wants to go take a Seattle team on right now, home or away, because Seattle proved their worth. They went into Philadelphia and beat them. They put a pretty good beating on them. They didn't go too crazy on them. They won only by 10 points, 24-14. But still, Philadelphia hadn't lost a game at home all year. And now Seattle coming in, they were 3-3 on the road this season, came in and beat a pretty good Philadelphia team. Mark Sanchez didn't even throw for 100 yards in this game, Grant.
Yeah, and I was, even though the score kind of suggested differently, I was actually watching the game, and it wasn't really a close game at all, even though that the score suggests otherwise. It was a sloppy game by the Eagles. There wasn't much offense at all. Just the Seahawks were wearing them down. And yeah, it was just not a very good showing by the Eagles, and just showing that the Seahawks, even though they had a slow start to the season, they're definitely a team to be reckoned with.
Yeah, now this Seattle team certainly can still get a first round bye if they play their cards right the rest of the season. But three games remaining. Seattle definitely a team to be reckoned with, like you said. Some other teams still fighting for contention. The Detroit Lions, they got a win over just an awful Tampa Bay Buccaneers team. Really no contest down the line. The Lions, 34-17 victors over the Buccaneers. Matthew Stafford, 300-plus passing yards, three touchdowns. Calvin Johnson, 158 yards, one touchdown. He had a great game. I mean, the Lions are starting to look like a real team and not having that late season fizzle out like normally we expect from them at this point in time, Grant. But you know, it's hard to really still put all your chips on the Detroit Lions, because if you're a betting man, which I don't know, are you a betting man, Grant?
No, I'm not a betting man.
Not a betting man. Well, you just had a baby. You got to save all your nickels and dimes and shekels. Right, right. So do what you got to do. But, you know, I wouldn't bet the house on the Lions yet. I don't know if I'd really bet the house on any team right now in the playoff picture, just because.
Right. How close it is.
Exactly. And, AFC and NFC.
And looking at the Lions' schedule, they don't have a very difficult schedule. They have the Vikings coming up, which, depending how the Vikings play, the Vikings aren't a horrible team.
They're an okay team.
It just depends on how the Vikings show up. That's not going to be an easy game for them, but it's a game that I think they should win.
Yeah.
They also have another matchup against the Bears, and the Bears are just
in Chicago.
In Chicago, but that's still kind of, the Bears are a wild card team. It seems like one week they show up, and then when the next couple weeks when you want them to show up, they don't.
Yeah.
So I don't think that'll be a loss for the Lions either. I think that key game is going to be Week 17 at Lambeau Field. It's going to be a huge game, even for both teams. I do think Green Bay will come on top with that one, but the Lions are definitely not out of the playoff picture at all.
No, by no means at all. And I had the opportunity to watch the Vikings beat up on the Jets for their game, and I was actually very impressed. I know the game went into overtime, but I still thought the Vikings defense in the first half was phenomenal. The first pass of the game by Geno Smith was picked off and ran back for a touchdown. Teddy Bridgewater, he's only a rookie. He's playing much better than I think we've ever seen him. Jarius Wright and Charles Johnson, Greg Jennings, two out of the three of those guys, younger wide receivers, really stepping up for the Vikings. And yeah, I worked it out with the NFL playoff machine at ESPN.com. The Vikings can't make the playoffs no matter if everybody lost every single game the rest of the year, and the Vikings were to win out. So it's unfortunate, because I think this Vikings team is, as Ryan put it last time, finally peaking at the right time, but even though there's no such thing as peaking, but I think they found their, their momentum. That's the right word, is they found their momentum at the right point in the season. So we'll see. I really don't know what to do with this Vikings team. I think that they will give the Lions a lot more trouble than I think people will believe them to going into the game.
Yeah, and I always think that the Vikings are going to come out with a really good team, and that they're always going to be scary at the beginning of the season, and then they drop five games within the we drop five games within the first seven. So it's always tough to see how they're going to do, but if they keep this momentum going up in the next season, I definitely think they're a team to be reckoned with, and I think they finally have found the answer at quarterback.
Yeah.
If Bridgewater can stay healthy, because he is performing phenomenally. So I think the Vikings have found a gem of a quarterback. They finally have a decent receiving core. If they get Adrian Peterson back, which that's still a question mark, which
yeah,
it's not looking very likely, but if they do keep him, which I think they should, I think it would be a bonehead decision to get rid of him, they would have a fantastic running back, and then their defense is pulling themselves together. So I think they're going to be a pretty decent team going into next season, even though this one's pretty much over.
All right. Well, Grant, out of all the games that happened this weekend, was there one performance by a specific team that really jumped out at you at all, or a surprise game that really, you know, shook up your feelings on how – I mean, the NFL as a whole is impossible. Like, I'm so glad I don't play Vegas, because I would have lost all my money years ago, because there's no way to bet consistently in the NFL with what kind of craziness happens every week. But Grant, what team really stood out to you this week?
two teams.
Okay.
One negatively and one positively.
Yes, lay it on me.
Positively.
Yes.
The Steelers went to Cincinnati and kicked the crap out of the Bengals. It was absolutely fantastic. It was a huge game for them. They still have their second game against the Bengals at Pittsburgh. These are going to be huge because Cincinnati going into the week was still at the top of the standings, and they still are for the AFC North. But now Pittsburgh is right at their heels, and they still have another game, and how they played this past week proves that, and still in my mind, that the Steelers are going to win out the division and make it into the playoffs. Now, the team that disappointed me, that I was just really sad to see, was the Cleveland Browns, because to me, with this loss, even though it's against a good Colts team, they did not do very well.
I don't even know if you can call the Colts a good team right now.
They're not a bad team, but if you look at their top passer, top rusher, and top receiving stats, Hoyer threw for 140 yards, zero touchdowns. Crowell, 54 yards, one touchdown. And Cameron, for the receivers, just 41 yards, no touchdowns. Not an extremely impressive performance on offense. They did not generate much on offense. And with that loss, it's not looking good for them going into the playoffs, making it at all, seeing as Baltimore, Pittsburgh, and Cincinnati all now have a game on them.
Yeah, I honestly don't think the Browns are going to have much of a chance of really of making the playoffs going forward. So it'll be a weird conclusion to the rest of the season. So we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to chat a little bit about the updated NFL playoff picture and talk a little bit more football in general. This is the Bax and Grant Sports Show. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to the Bax and Grant Sports Show. Grant is dancing and moving to the grooving, and he's certainly playing that funky music. He's breaking it down. It's unfortunately this is only an audio show, because if there were cameras, well, we might break the internet. So this is the Bax and Grant Sports Show. Baxter Colburn alongside Grant Coppersmith. Grant, a little bit of an interesting weekend in NFL football. It's not over yet. The Green Bay Packers play the Atlanta Falcons tonight. We'll get to that a little bit later on in the show. I want to play with the NFL playoff machine here, courtesy of ESPN.com, a little bit. I'm giving the Packers the benefit of the doubt tonight that they're going to win their game and move forward with that going into next week. Arizona will be the first seed, Green Bay second, Philly third, Atlanta four, Seattle five, and Detroit six. Going down the rest of the way, though, I want to talk about these six teams that are in the playoff picture right now. Arizona takes on St. Louis next week. How do you think they do?
I'm tempted to say that St. Louis could possibly pull this game out. It's a little difficult to say, but I would like to see them win. I think they can pull it off with how they played this last week, and that they're actually not a bad team. They just had a pretty rough start at the beginning of the year, lost a couple tough games. But if a couple of those games went the other way, they would have a winning record right now, and they'd actually be in the playoff hunt. And Arizona's on the decline right now. So I think that you can say that, I'm going to predict that the Rams will win next
week. Yeah, no, I agree with that. I think the Rams defend their home turf, beat the Cardinals. Staying in week 15, I think Pittsburgh beats Atlanta. I like the Giants beating the Redskins. Dolphins, Patriots, games in Foxborough, Grant. What do you think about that one?
I'm definitely thinking the New England Patriots on that one.
Yep, that would be my first bet, too. Raiders traveling to Kansas City. Raiders riding their two games that they've won this season. Can they beat the Chiefs, or is it just, no, not going to happen?
Even though the Chiefs are beat up and a little rough, I think the Chiefs are still a better team.
Yeah, I completely agree. The Texans at the Colts, that's a weird game because the Texans are now in the playoff picture. They were in the playoff picture last week, but a win this coming week at Indianapolis would really shake up the entire AFC playoff picture. Does Houston have what it takes to beat the Colts?
I don't think so. I just think Andrew Luck and the Colts are just a little bit better than J.J. Watt.
Yeah.
Because honestly, Houston Texans, in my opinion, are J.J. Watt.
That's true. So, that's all they really have. Yeah, that makes sense. I think Baltimore is a complete wash over Jacksonville. Jacksonville's not going to be able to do anything. Green Bay and Buffalo, is that a trap game for the Packers, or do they have what it takes to take out the Bills?
It can, but the Green Bay Packers definitely have to be careful, but I think they're going to get the win. But if there was ever a game that they were going to lose this the last four games of the season that they still have to play, it would be against the Bills.
All right.
But I think they'll be able to win.
Well, let's assume for a second the Packers lose. All right, so the Packers lose, Bills win. Carolina's going to beat Tampa Bay. Not worried about that. Cincy and Cleveland.
I'm going to say Cincinnati.
Yeah, me as well. I think the Jets will beat the Titans. That game has no playoff significance, so I don't really care about that. Broncos at the Chargers.
That'll be an interesting game. I'm going to say the Broncos.
Yeah, I completely agree with that. Vikings at the Lions. I want Minnesota to win this game for more than one reason, obviously, but it's at Detroit. Detroit 6-1 this year at home. Is it realistic?
As much as we want it so, I think that the Lions will pull out a win next week.
Yeah, I agree. 49ers at Seattle. I like Seattle. No question asked about that one. Dallas goes to Philly. That's a weird game.
Yeah, that's a pretty big game, too.
It really is.
Looking at all the different spots that these teams are right now, they're both tied at the top of the NFC East.
Yes.
So it'll definitely be an interesting game.
I think Philly will rebound from their embarrassment to the Seahawks, personally. I know Detroit or Dallas is coming off a win as well because they beat the Bears on Thursday Night Football.
Right.
I like the Eagles winning this game.
All right, we'll go with you on this one right now. We'll go with you.
And then Saints and Bears.
I'm going to have to go with the Saints.
Yeah, I don't really feel like the Bears have much of anything left in the tank, honestly. So after Week 15, the AFC looks like the Patriots, Broncos, the 1 and 2 seeds, Indy at 3, Cincy at 4, Pittsburgh at 5, Baltimore at 6, NFC, Seattle and Detroit 1 and 2 respectively, Philly 3, New Orleans 4, Arizona 5, Green Bay 6, assuming that they lose. Grant, walk us through week 16.
All right, I'd say another insignificant game, but I'll say Tennessee over Jacksonville.
Has no playoff. Anything.
Yeah, Eagles over the Redskins.
Yep.
I'm gonna say the Chargers take it to San Fran.
Yep.
And then actually the Vikings beat the Dolphins.
Ooh, an interesting pick. Dolphins playoff hopes all but gone at this point. Especially if that's how they end up, they would be 7-8 at that point. Disappointing from the Dolphins, really.
Yeah, they did have a promising beginning of the season.
I expected better. As I think most Dolphin fans do agree. Right.
But then moving on, I think that the Ravens will beat the Texans.
Yep.
Lions will beat the Bears.
Yep.
And the Browns will finally pull out a win over the Panthers.
Okay.
And then a big game for the worst division in football.
It's not even, it shouldn't even be allowed to be a division anymore.
No. But I'm going to say that the Saints win this one primarily because they're just the more experienced team, and it's also going to be at home. So that'll be a much wanted advantage for them. Green Bay over the Bucks, that shouldn't be too difficult for them.
Not worried about that game, no.
You know, Steelers over the Chiefs.
Yep. Patriots.
Pats over the Jets, not a problem. And Rams over the Giants. The Rams are, even though their record is poor, they're, like I've said, they're still a much better team that people give them credit for.
Yeah, I completely agree with that.
I think the Buffalo Bills over Oakland.
Yep, no question about that.
Another
Indy and Dallas. In Dallas, what do you got?
I think Dallas is the better team, even though that Andrew Luck is the better quarterback.
That's true. We'll see.
Okay. Discussion for later.
Exactly.
Seattle over Arizona.
Yep.
And I'm going to take the Broncos over the Bengals.
Yeah, that's a fair assumption. I don't see why that doesn't change anything. Grants, what's the AFC look like then after week 16?
AFC, in the first two seeds, we have New England first, Denver in second.
Realistically, those spots probably aren't going to change. They're going to flip-flop. That's all it's really going to be if anything happens.
Pittsburgh third, Indianapolis fourth, Baltimore in the fifth seed, and Cincinnati in the sixth seed.
Okay.
And the NFC, the first seed is Seattle, second Detroit, third Philly, fourth New Orleans, fifth seed, Green Bay, and sixth seed is Arizona.
Huh, that Arizona going to Philly game, an interesting one. Green Bay going back to the Superdome in New Orleans. Something to think about. Week 17, Grant. Panthers, Falcons. That's just a toss-up game, honestly.
I'd say the Falcons because they have more to... They have a lot more on the line. I think they're going to be gung-ho.
Yeah, I think so. Falcons win that game. Ravens over the Browns, no question. Dallas over Washington.
Well, I'd argue that there's some question.
You think the Browns will beat the Ravens?
No, but to say that there's no question, I have a little arguing to do about that. Because the Browns aren't a bad team.
They're not. They're Baltimore's better.
Yes, but they're just a little bit of a downturn. But they were neck and neck with Baltimore all season up until this point.
They were.
So I think it's unfair to the team by say it's no question.
I think I appreciate your opinion. That's why I love you. But I think that the fact that the Browns losing to the Colts the way they did this last week is going to ruin the rest of their season and they're not going to be able to fully recover. Right. Colts over the Titans. No problem about that. I like Green Bay beating the Lions.
I do. I think that game in Detroit was a fluke.
Yeah.
It was at the beginning of the season. The Green Bay Packers were warming up, or whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
Whatever Ryan wants to call it. but at Lambeau Field, I definitely think Green Bay can take that one.
Yeah, I have no argument about that whatsoever. Moving on from there, Houston over the Jaguars, San Diego over Kansas City. Even with whoever wins that game, no playoff implications on the line anymore. Both teams are out of contention. Miami over the Jets. Minnesota over the Bears. New England over Buffalo. Even if they did lose, all it would do is cost them the first or second seed. Really doesn't change much. Philly over the Giants. Doesn't change really anything right now. If Philly were to lose that game, though, Philly would move from a 2 seed down to a 3rd seed, so they would not get the first round bye, but Philly wins that game. I think Pittsburgh is going to still beat up on Cincinnati once more. And I think New Orleans will get their 8th win of the year, finish off 8-8, and win the division after beating the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Even if they lost that game, they would still win the division. Even if Atlanta does end up beating the Panthers, it doesn't change anything. Panthers win or Falcons win, Saints still have the edge. Denver over Oakland, even if Denver somehow loses that game, doesn't change anything for them. Arizona against San Fran. Interesting thing, if Arizona wins the last week of the season, they will end up as the 5th seed.
Based on our predictions.
Yes, if they lose, they're completely out of the playoffs.
Interesting.
Something to think about. Rams at the Seahawks. I want to pick the Rams, but I just don't think it's possible. Right. Seattle wins. So the NFL playoffs, as if they were to go this way, the way Grant and I have just predicted them, over in the AFC, New England and Denver 1-2. Wild card games would then be the 6th seed San Diego going to Pittsburgh, who's the 3rd seed, and Baltimore, the 5th seed, going to Indianapolis, the 4th seed. NFC, Seattle with the 1st seed, Green Bay with the 2nd. Seattle has the advantage, even though they're both 12-4. Seattle beat Green Bay week 1, both with first round byes. Detroit, the 6th seed, going to Philly, the 3rd seed. Arizona, the 5th seed, traveling to New Orleans, the 4th seed. Wow. San Diego there, if you noticed, kind of snuck in out of nowhere.
Right.
San Diego.
They seem to do that every year, though.
They do.
They do that every year. They're kind of like an underrated team, but they're still a pretty good team.
Yeah.
And then they get to the playoffs, and everybody's like, well, where did they come from? And then they just struggle to the championship game and then lose to New England.
Usually how it works, yeah. San Diego would have to go 2-1 the rest of the season based on our predictions. We have San Diego going 2-1, finishing 10-6. Looking around, there's really no other teams that would have been snubbed as you were. Buffalo would have gone 9-7. Cincy, 9-6-1. Houston, 8-8. Kansas City, 8-8. So there's really no big misses. The NFC, that's a whole other story, though, because you would have the Cowboys missing the playoffs at 11-5. You really don't have much else after that. St. Louis goes 8-8, Atlanta 6-10, Minnesota 8-8. There's really no other
snubs. It's kind of nice looking at how it was looking a couple weeks ago when all these teams had the same record, and we were just thinking of how is this going to work?
Like,
we're going to end up with a couple teams that have the same record, and it's going to be down to like some ridiculous yard stat that this one team isn't going to, like these couple teams aren't going to make it to the playoffs, and this one team is. So it was, to me, it's kind of fixing itself, and I'm getting a little bit okay with this. New Orleans would have, if everything is predicted correctly, which it's probably not.
You never know. Yeah, the NFL is weird, though.
But New Orleans would have an 8-8 record, which Green Bay last year, 8-8.
Yeah.
And that would be better for me. I would feel much better about the NFC South if that happened.
It's a whole... I don't have enough words.
It's a mess.
It really is. But Grant, it's time for our favorite part of the show, Grant's Rant. All right, for those of you that don't know, Grant gets 30 seconds to rant about whatever he wants in the sports world. Uncensored. I always joke about being unclothed. You have your clothes on today, thankfully.
I do.
I
always do.
That's true. They don't need to know that. It's a mystery. Are you ready? You ready to
answer? I am ready.
Okay. You have 30 seconds. On your mark. Get set. Go.
I'm actually going to change this up on you, Bax. So what I'm going to rant about today is the Oakland Raiders winning their second game.
Okay.
After they won their second game, they gave their coach a Gatorade shower.
Oh, my goodness.
It's absolutely ridiculous. Second game in December, no less, and you feel the need to celebrate it. I feel like that is an extremely tabooed thing to do. It's pretty much just for like conference wins or divisional wins, like big ones at the end of the season.
Time is
up. Super Bowl.
Oakland Raiders, they're getting a Gatorade bath. They're going to the playoffs. No, just kidding. It's not going to happen.
Playoffs?
Playoffs? You talking about playoffs, guys? All right, this is the Bax and Grant Sports Show. We're going to take a break. When we come back, little Green Bay Atlanta preview. Don't go anywhere. Bang on that drum, Grant. Bang on that drum. Bax and Grant Sports Show back again. Grant and I are stoked more than just one reason. Yeah, it's Green Bay Packers game day, hence the reason, a little bang on the drum. I mean, you gotta bang on the drum.
Always. We're gonna be hearing that sweet, sweet sound a lot tonight.
Oh, yeah. Green Bay Packers taking on the Atlanta Falcons tonight. Monday Night Football. Ba, 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 ba. It's an exciting time. It got even more exciting today, Grant. Do you know why?
Why?
Because Brett Favre is going to be at the game tonight. Brett freaking Favre is going to be at the game. I feel like a kid again. The news broke today that Brett Favre would be at the game. Bart Starr Jr. will be at the game. No confirmation yet if Bart Starr himself will be at the game. But Brett Favre, the man, the myth, the enigma, he will be at the game tonight.
Yeah, and I think that's extremely appropriate. They're going to be honoring Bart Starr at the game. Still, yeah, we still don't know if he's going to be there because he's had an he had a lot of health conditions going in to or during this season that actually prolonged Brett Favre. He was going to show up earlier this season, but because of Bart Starr's health, he's not going to. But I think it's extremely appropriate that he's going to be there. I think it's well overdue. The last time Brett Favre was at Lambeau, he was in a purple jersey, which it makes us all sick how it went down.
It hurts to think, in my opinion,
I think it was the right time to get rid of him. I think Rodgers was ready. I know some people don't hold that same opinion, but that's for a different time. But I hold no remorse against him. I think he pulled us out of a dark era that we're not going to talk about. That was like 30 years of not dominant Packer football, or about 20 years of non-dominant Packer football.
I suppose.
And he really was a strong part of pulling us out of that.
It's true.
So
that's very true.
I'm really happy that he's going to be back. I hope that the fans receive him well. I am a little nervous about it because after he left, which he didn't really leave, he kind of got kicked.
Well,
he kind of
got
booted. There was some pretty strong remarks against him. So I'm a little nervous, but I honestly think that Packer fans should just get over the fact that he went to the Jets and that he later went to the Vikings. And the past is in the past. He wanted to play football. We said, we're done with you. And he went to find teams that wanted him to play football. So honestly, I think it was just a mutual. Just both teams or both sides are done. It's done. Just leave it alone. Pass in the past.
Yes.
Welcome home,
yes.
our golden boy.
For exactly.
16 years.
Well, it's interesting because while you were doing that, Grant, you were serenading me with your lovely voice. I just was on Twitter and saw some sad news that Brett Favre has actually left Green Bay.
Oh.
Again.
Sad.
He will not be at the game tonight, as confirmed by numerous sources, which is unfortunate. But he was here to honor Bart Starr today at the Brett Favre Steakhouse in Green Bay. But he is now on his way back to Mississippi. So, I'm a little upset.
That's sad.
I'm a little upset. Not
breaking news.
Not breaking
sadness.
News. Very sad.
Well, they will be retiring his number. They said sometime
eventually,
in the near future.
Yeah.
There was rumors about next season, but with Bart Starr's health, that's a little iffy. So, we'll see.
Yeah. But, so I'm a little disappointed by that.
Yeah.
But, you heard it here first. Breaking news, Brett Favre will not be at the Green Bay Packers game tonight. So, a little sad, unfortunate. But, hey, at least he came back for something. He came back to help honor a good friend, Bart Starr, and did a lot of good while he was here. So, looking forward to the game tonight. Packers-Falcons. A few different things to look at. The biggest thing that jumps out at me, Grant, is Atlanta's 32nd ranked pass defense going against a guy like Aaron Rodgers.
Right,
that's not what you want to have going forward. Packers pass offense ranked
eighth
in the top 10. Yeah, ranked eighth. Aaron Rodgers having himself an MVP caliber season, currently ranked number one in the MVP rankings. According to fansided.com, Evan Massey writing an article ranking the top five MVP candidates through week 14. Aaron Rodgers, number one. J.J. Watt, number two. Number three is a bit surprising to me, Andrew Luck.
You don't like him.
I'm getting the feeling. We'll get to him in fact
or
fiction. But then Tom Brady at four and Peyton Manning at five. Andrew Luck at three. I think that's a little too generous for my liking personally.
I guess that makes sense if you're putting him ahead of Peyton Manning and Tom Brady. That makes sense. That does make sense why you would. It's a little iffy.
Yeah, I suppose. But it's hard to really get behind somebody like that. That's a little inconsistent. But anyway, who is the biggest factor for the Packers tonight that needs to show up aside from Aaron Rodgers for the Packers to win this game tonight?
In my opinion, I just think the receiving core, that they had an excellent game against the Patriots. Jordy Nelson and Randall Cobb were pretty much covered up, though. So I don't know if that got their heads a little rattled. I doubt it. Jordy Nelson still had a fantastic play. But just to open that up for Aaron Rodgers, especially to exploit the lack of pass defense that the Falcons have, I think if they step up tonight, Devontae Adams even, if he can, if he played minus that crucial drop, if he played as well as he did last week, that's just adding another factor. And then just imagine, let's get a little crazy here. Woo! And looking to next season.
Yeah.
If we keep all these guys and we also have Corliss and Rodgers, as our tight end. And then coming off of the injury, Jared Aberderis, because he was injured earlier this year and he hasn't played at all.
That's true.
So if he's still around and we still have him, pretty interesting receiving core.
We have, I would argue we have one of the best, if not the best, receiving cores in the NFL.
Right.
I don't think you can really argue with that. I don't think any team can really raise a finger to what the Packers have in terms of depth. And even guys on the practice squad, too. We've got some solid young wide receivers that have developed properly, like Kevin Dorsey and Miles White. I think we could have a terrific, consistent wide receiving core for many, many years to come.
Right. But yeah, just going up, just bringing it back to who needs to step it up. Not necessarily just step it up, just perform as they have been, just to give Aaron Rodgers the weapons and just to exploit the Falcons' defense as much as possible. Because the Falcons' worst, like their biggest weakness, is the Packers' biggest strength. So they need to exploit that as much as possible, and maybe even getting Eddie Lacy involved, a lot involved. I think he's not getting involved enough. These past couple weeks he's had.
Eddie Lacy's played really well. I heard he's over 200 yards rushing total the last two games, like combined.
Right.
Which hasn't happened for a Packers running back in a while.
Yeah, the last one to do it was probably Starks, and before him, Amon Green. So
yeah, well, I mean, Amon Green, you can't really argue with how well he's done over his career. Just a fantastic player.
Right.
Another thing, too, for tonight, Matt Ryan, somebody that can go off on a moment's notice. He's Atlanta has the fifth best pass offense in the NFL. Green Bay's pass defense, 11th. They're getting a lot better than where they used to be. Matt Ryan against the Packers secondary. Do you like that matchup, or does Matt Ryan have a field day with these Packers young corners?
I think with how the Packers defense performed last week against the Patriots and how they've been doing all season, they have surpassed my expectations. I was thinking it was going to be another offense-heavy year, that the defense was just kind of going to show up maybe a couple weeks when they needed to. That was going to be it. But they have been doing fantastic this year, sticking it to Tom Brady and holding him and the Patriots to 21 points. Absolutely ridiculous.
That's true.
So if they can hold Tom Brady and the Patriots to 21 points, I see them having no problem against the Falcons.
Yeah, I think that Matt Ryan is a dangerous quarterback, but he's been very inconsistent this whole season and does not deserve to be in the conversation as one of the better quarterbacks this year. He's got 21 touchdowns to his name, 3,427 total yards, completed 306 out of his 465 passes. So it's not terrible. Steven Jackson, good running back, but he is well past his prime, and I don't think he's really got much left in the tank. Grant, final score prediction, Packers, Falcons?
Falcons 14, Packers 31.
All right. I like the Packers going 28-17 over the Falcons. So we're going to take a fast break. When we come back, we're going to play Fact or Fiction and wrap things up. This is the Bax and Grant Sports Show. Welcome back to the Bax and Grant Sports Show. Baxter and Grant here with you. Pretty jazzed for the Packers-Falcons game tonight. Both Grant and I taking the Packers over the Falcons. Grant, what was your score? You said 31 to 14. I have the Packers 28-17 over the Falcons. Sad news, though. Brett Favre will not be at the game tonight after being in Green Bay for a luncheon to honor Bart Starr. So a little sad. I'm upset about it, but I think we'll survive. So you ready for a little fact or fiction, Grant?
I'm ready.
All right, fact or fiction, Grant, that Wisconsin will beat Auburn in their bowl game.
I mean, after the demoralizing, to say the least, defeat at the hands of Ohio State, I think they need to win this game. I take them as fact, but they need this win because they need some shred of dignity for the way they played. After the game, I came up to you and I said, so Wisconsin Badgers never play football and we're never going to talk about it ever again because it's just how bad they played. But I think they're not a bad team. They're an excellent team. The way they played Ohio State is not Wisconsin Badger football. I will take them as fact.
Okay. I also say I think fiction. I think Auburn's too good of a team, and I think that they will run over Wisconsin. Fact or fiction, Grant, that the Packers have the best quarterbacks in NFL history, mainly Bart Starr, Aaron Rodgers, and Brett Favre.
As a whole, as a franchise,
they have had the best quarterbacks.
I'd say fact.
Okay.
Even though, not to get me wrong, there has been franchises with fantastic quarterbacks. There's too many to count. There's
Montana and Young in San Francisco.
Right. There's plenty of quarterbacks that we can mention.
Yeah.
But star quarterbacks, if you, and in the top 10, I think you could fit, maybe not the top 10.
No.
Top 25 quarterbacks, you may be able to fit all three of these guys.
I would agree with that.
That might be a slight stretch, but I think it's a possibility you could put all three of those guys in there. And the Packers have seen them on their rosters at some point in their franchise history, and I don't think another team can say that.
Yeah, yep, I agree. Fiction or fact as well. I think Packers definitely have three of the best quarterbacks in NFL history. Grant, fact or fiction that Andrew Luck will win the MVP award this season?
That's fiction. I don't think he's a very solid quarterback. I think he's a good quarterback, but he's not better than or having a better season than Aaron Rodgers.
Yeah.
Or Peyton Manning or Tom Brady.
Yes. Yep, I also say that is fiction. Andrew Luck, he's got a long way to go before he gets to the same level as Brady, Manning, and Rodgers. And final question, fact or fiction, Grant, that the college football playoff system needs to be expanded to 8 teams in the very near future.
Fiction, it needs to be expanded to 16 teams.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
I feel that right now it needs some major rehaul, and 16 teams is where it needs to be.
Wow. Wow, I think that's, yeah, okay.
maybe not right away. If
no,
saying
I think
right
that's,
away,
to go from 4 to 16 would be suicide.
I think you would need to do 8 teams at first to kind of ease people into it.
Yeah.
But eventually, within the next 5 years, it needs to get to 16 teams, in my opinion.
Okay.
Because in my opinion, this college football playoff system is extremely broken.
All right. Well, I think that is... fact, I think they need to expand to 8 teams, not 16, at least in the near future. So, we'll see. This has been another edition of the Bax and Grant Sports Show. Thank you so much for listening. Baxter Colburn, Grant Coppersmith. Until next time, go Pack, go, and have a great rest of your night, ladies and gentlemen.